Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we are going to study about stack. Stack is a one kind of linear data structure. Linear data structure means that kind of data structure where we store the data in a sequential manner, right? Suppose I have stored one data A at 1024 location, and suppose it takes 2 byte per memory, so my B would be stored at 1026 location, and so on. That means it's in a sequential manner, right? So that is my linear data structure. So stack is a one kind of linear data structure that we are having, and it is an ordered collection of items. Ultimately, data structure, we use data structure to store the data where we can access the data efficiently, and the insertion and deletion can take place very efficiently. That is the purpose of data structure. So stack is an ordered collection of items in which items may be inserted or deleted at one end only, right? Now what it means, like we can take one example of suppose we are having pile of CDs, right? So suppose this is a CD stand we are having. So here one CD is there, then another CD is there, and then the next one, right? So if I want to insert any CD, then I can insert over here, right? And if I want to remove any CD, then that also I have to do from this end only, because this one end is already fixed, right? I cannot access this end, right? So the same funda I'm having in stack, that one end is fixed, right? So I can insert or delete any data from the one end only. And that's why it is called, like, stack is called as LIFO data structure. LIFO data structure, that means last in, first out. That means whichever items is inserted last, that would be the first one to be removed, right? So that is LIFO data structure, and in stack we follow LIFO data structure. We can take another example that for example, we can take technical example like recursion, right? We are having recursion, or we can say like function. We are having multiple functions. Let us take, we are having multiple functions, right? So suppose my main function call function A, right? Then function A will call function B, right? So this function A will be pushed to my stack, right? And then I'm having this function B. Why? Because function A call function B, right? That's why function B is again pushed to my stack, right? And then suppose function C, function B call function C, right? And then when function C is completed, it will return a value to function B. So I can remove this function B, function C, so it can be popped out, right? So I'll have something like this. I'm having only function A and function B, right? Then if function B has been completed its work and it will return some value, so I have to pop up this function B also. So I'm having only function A, right? And as soon as function A will complete its task and return its value to the main function, right? So I have to pop this out also, right? So this is something we can we use this in a function also, that is also stack, right? So I have been repeatedly telling that push and pop, right? So why I'm telling push and pop? So if I am inserting any data, right, so that insertion is known as push. If I talk about stack data structure, so insertion operation, that is known as push operation, right? And deletion, that deletion operation is known as pop operation, right? So if I say I'm pushing something to my stack, that means I'm pushing any element to I'm inserting any element to my stack, right? And if I'm saying that here I have popped out the function B, that means I'm deleting the data from my stack, right? So that is the basic definition of push and pop. And one more thing, that suppose we are having this stack, right? So we can insert at the one, as you know that we can insert at the one and only, and the at the same and only we can delete the items, right? So to keep a track of that particular item, so what is the topmost item we are having in the stack, right? So for that we are having one pointer that is called as top pointer, right? So the working of top pointer, it's just to point out the topmost element from in my stack, right? So if I say in this my top element is function of C, right? Here my top element is function is B. Here I am having function of A, right? So suppose like let us take one example that by default I am having this empty stack, right? And it will again start with 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, right? Suppose I am having this, right? This is my stack A, right? Suppose I am having this stack A, right? Now by default I am having nothing here, right? So I have to initialize some base value to my top, right? So what I can do, that I can assign the value that is top is equal to minus 1. That is the by default value of my pointer top, right? Now if I insert any element, right, that means if I push any element to my stack, for example, let us say any number 5, right? So if I am inserting any number 5 to my stack, so 5 will be stored over here, this would be blank, right? So I am having the 0, 1, 2, 3 and a 4. So now my top is this, right? That is 0. Then again if I insert any other element, so suppose I am having this 5 and I am inserting 10, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3 and I am having this 4. So now my top is 1, right? Now if I insert one more element, right? So suppose 15, so 5, 10 and 15, that there is no need to worry about the second end because it's already fixed, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, right? So now my top is 2, right? So as you can see that here top is incrementing each and every time, right? Top is incrementing each and every time, right? So this is the push operation, right? So like so someone asked me to write the algorithm for push push operation, right? So what I can do, that this is the simple operation I'm having, that's a push operation, right? That is insertion operation. And I'm using this like suppose for storage purpose I use array, right? I can use to implement stack. Stack can be implemented in two way, right? One that is using array and second that is using linked list, right? So right now we are going to study like that is a stack using array only, right? Later on we'll see how to implement stack using linked list also, right? So right now I'm using array to implement the stack, right? So for that suppose I'm having the algorithm push, right? So what it can have, so it can have first the stack, that is the name of my array, right? Suppose I'm having the name that is stack, right? Then the value, topmost value, right? And then I can say element that I need to insert, right? So this three things I need to pass on into my function, right? Suppose if I'm writing an algorithm for push or writing a function for a push, right? So this three things I need to insert, right? I need to pass on, right? First, that is a array, right? Here which I named as a stack, right? The second thing is the topmost element and the third one is the element that I want to insert in my stack. I want to push in my stack, right? So what would be the step one? So if you see that step one, first of all I need to check, what I need to check, here I am using array, right? For implementing stack I am using array, and as you know that It's a finite state array is having finite memory, right? So like we need to initialize static memory, you can say, right? Array is using static memory. When we use linked list, it will use dynamic memory, so there is no concern with the memory, right? But here array is using static memory. So static, that means I need to initialize my array first of all. That means I need to initialize my stack first of all with a particular size. That means it have limits, right? If I implement stack using linked list, then there is no limit, right? I can insert as much element, as more element as I can, as I want, right? But here I'm implementing this using array. That means it has some particular limit, right? So suppose that when I initialize that array stack, at that time I have given the size, for example, let us say 5, right? So that size of my array is 5, right? So I can store only 5 element into my stack, no more than that, right? So if there is some condition I should have to check the condition, because if already 5 elements are there in my stack, then I'm not able to insert any more element, right? And if then also if I am able to insert, then it will replace some of the values, right? That is not feasible, right? So for that we have to first of all check the condition that whether my stack is having empty, or you can say vacant space, or not, right? If it have the vacant space, then I will allow it to insert into it, right? But if it does not have any vacant space, then there should be some error message, or you can say message that sorry, we don't have space, and you can say overflow message, something kind of that. So for that you need to here write down some condition. So that condition, what I need to check, I'm using simple F. This is algorithm, so I'm writing in a simple manner, right? So if now how can I check, right? So as you can see that the topmost element that is pointed by the top pointer, right, and my size is 5. So as you can see that it will start from 0. If the size is 5, it will go up to 4, right? Only up to 4. And so it can store this much only, right? It is bounded, right? So it can store this much element only, no more than that, right? So I can check that if my top element is already equal to 4. Here it's a 4, right? So suppose it is defined in size, so it should be size minus 1, right? So if the top is equal to size minus 1, then there is overflow. So I'm just writing that print overflow, right? And if overflow occurs, that means what? I have to return from here, right? I cannot go further for the next step, because insertion is not allowed for me, because there is no vacant space. So I'm writing return over here, right? So that's my step 1. So first of all, before inserting any of the element, it will check whether there is a vacant space or not, right? And then if there is a no vacant space, then it will return back. But if there is a vacant space, then it will go to the next step, that is step 2, right? Now what is the step 2 that what I need to do? Suppose I am having here 5 already, right? And if I want to store one more element, right? So what I need to do, it will be stored at the 1th position, and right now my top is at the 0th position. So what I need to do, I need to increment my top, right? That is a basic thing. Here also top is equal to minus 1. There is nothing on my stack, right? So it will increment by 1. So minus 1 plus 1, that's a 0, right? So whatever the item that would be stored over here, then 0 plus 1, then 1, right? Then 1 plus 1, it's a 2, then 2 plus 1, that's a 3, right? And so on, right? So what I need to do, I need to increment the pointer, right? So for this incrementing my pointer, what I need to do, that is top plus plus, right? That's a simple thing. You can write as well, top is equal to top plus 1, both are same, right? Then what would be the next step after incrementing the top? The next step would be I need to store it, right? I need to store a particular element that is given by the user here, right? That element is given by the user, that I need to store it at my array step. And at which index? That index is given by top, right? So that is stack of top that is equal to element, right? Stack of top that is equal to element. That means I'm storing this element into my array called stack and at the index top, right? And that's all, nothing more. So last step would be step 4. That is either I should return from that function or like we can end this, right? Next we need to study the pop operation, right? So the pop operation, that's a simple deletion operation. We can say that it's a deletion, right? So for that I'll just explain the logic behind that, then we'll move forward to the algorithm, right? So suppose, as I explained earlier, I'm having stack of size 5, right? So this is my stack A and the size is 5, right? Now what I need to do, that suppose I'm having here element 3 5 7 9, right? So my topmost element is here, right? And if I want to delete that element, so I need to pop this out, right? So the next thing is my top should point to the 2, right? So in the next step, it would look something like the 0. At 1, I'm having this 5. At 2, I'm having this 7, right? At 3, that is blank. And 4, that is again blank. So now my top is pointed to 2, right? Then if I remove one more element, again the same thing we are having. That is 3, then 5, then 2. 3 and 4, and if I remove this 7, then my top should point to this 1, right? So it's a simple logic, right? So if I go for the algorithm, so first of all, step 1, now here also I need to check something, right? As we checked for the overflow in push operation, right? Here, assume that my stack is already empty, right? So if my stack is already empty, so then how I'm able to delete anything, right? So it will give some garbage value to me, right? So for that we need to check for the underflow, right? So here for the pop operation, what we are doing, we are checking for the underflow, right? So check for the underflow. In the previous one we have checked for the overflow, here we are checking for the underflow, right? So if you say that check for underflow, so there must be some condition, right? So what should be that condition? So as you can see, as I discussed earlier, that for the empty stack we are having one initial value of top, that if my top is equal to minus 1, then I can say that my stack is empty, right? So that condition I can use it over here, right? So if my top is equal to minus 1, right, then you can see that my stack is empty. So then you can print stack is empty. You can print anything, it's up to you, it's an error message, right? And then you have to return from here, because if the stack is empty, so there is no need to go further, right? And if it is not like that, then you have to go for the step 2, right? So what would be the step 2? Now you can say that it's simple, I'll decrement the top, right? That's fine. If you decrement the top, then it's completely okay. But suppose if you want to make a use of this element, because if you have pushed something to store, like for the storing purpose, and if you are deleting this, so before deleting that, you might be use it for something like to displaying it or anything, right? So for that you need this in some variable, right? So I'm just taking the some variable called var, right? and I'm storing the value, topmost value that that I'm going to delete. So before deleting that, I'm storing that value to some variable called var, right? So if I want to use it further for like displaying purpose or any purpose, so I can use it, right? Then step 3, that as you all know, simple, I need to decrement my top, so top minus minus, right? And the last step, so last step is exit or return. So that is step 4, either I'll exit or I return, right? So this is a very simple pop algorithm that we are having. Then one more algorithm is there, that is called as peep algorithm, right? So we can say it's a peep algorithm. Now peep algorithm is somewhat similar to pop algorithm, only the difference is peep means we are looking for something, right? So here we are looking for the topmost element, right? So peep will give you whatever is there in my topmost element, right? In my top, right? But it will not delete that value. It will not delete that value. So if I write the algorithm, it is somewhat same to the pop algorithm. The step 1, that would be checking for underflow. So check underflow, right? For checking the underflow, like I need the same condition, that is if top is equal to minus 1, then stack is empty, right? And if you are having this, you have to return from here, right? If it is not like that, then just I need to give that value to some variable for displaying purpose. So I am giving it to var, that is the topmost element, right? Now here I don't want to delete that value, I just want to display whatever is there on my topmost element, right? So that's all, right? So here I am not going to decrement my top variable. So simple step 3 would be exit or return, right? There is only one minor difference in between pop and peep, that is we are not deleting any element in my peep operation. Why whether in a like a pop operation we are deleting the topmost element we value, so we are decrementing the topmost element, right? Now as you can see that this is a basic application, basic algorithms are stack, push operation, pop operation and peep operation, right? Basic algorithms. Now if I talk about application, so what should be the application of this stack, right? So I can say that most probably stacks are used to evaluate any expression, right? So I can say for evaluating mathematical expression, right? That is my basic application of stack, right? And for evaluating any expression, I need to use postfix expression, right? So for converting, I need to convert. So for the conversion of infix to whether postfix or prefix, right? Postfix or prefix, right? For that also I need the stack, right? Now stacks are also used by the compilers, right? Compilers also use this to keep a track of each and everything, right? In many programming language, operating system also use this, right? And it will contain some memory environment and all that. So these are the basic applications of stack, but the most important application is to evaluate mathematical expression. You can see that compiler use it, for example, if you C language, so C compiler use it for keep a track of a function invocation, right? In a similar way, many compilers use it, right? and the most important is evaluation of mathematical expression, so that for conversion of infix and post infix, from infix to postfix or from infix to prefix, we need this tech, right? So in the next lecture, I'm going to explain this conversion from infix to postfix as well as conversion from infix to prefix. So I hope you all understand this. This is a very basic funda of STEC. Thank you.